Hey everyone, this is Andre from AndreLVaughn.com, and today we're going to discuss the 10 best WordPress plugins that are free for your blog or website. And this is a subjective 10 best or top 10 or whatever you want to call it. It's subjective, so these are just through my own experiences with different websites and what performs better with WordPress in terms of plugins. AskMet is one of the best spam protectors for WordPress. I believe it is the best. And what that does, it blocks different spam comments or different just people that's trying to or computers that are trying to intrude on your websites and in your comments and things of that nature. As you can see right here, I have highlighted it's at almost a 99% accuracy rate, and in the past, looks like the past 6 months, 51 spam attempts have been tried, and this thing works very well. So it's an awesome plugin. The Google Analytics plugin is really a no-brainer. I highly recommend this plugin. What it does, it enables Google Analytics on every page of your site, but you have to make sure that you set up a Google account. You can go to analytics.google.com or just do a Google search on Google Analytics and the page will pop up, and you can go in there and set up an account first. So make sure you do that. And once you got that squared away, you download the plugin. There's a video for you to watch, and there's a tutorial. That's why I have that circle. So that's very important. So make sure you do that first, and it'll pretty much tell you step by step what to do. So it's really not that hard anyway, so even without the video. And that's, you know, maybe it's just me talking and through my experiences, but you might be a super novice, so make sure you watch that video. The Google Analytics dashboard for WordPress. It's another very important. You ever see those charts of how different web or different bloggers, when they show you the traffic that's going to their website? That's what this is in a nutshell. This particular plugin, what it does, it'll show, this is just one screen right here where it's showing where the traffic is coming from to my website. And there's also a tab that shows I'm not sure how many, but it'll show, like on this screen, a location. It'll show the traffic, like where it's coming from, like if it's coming from Facebook or Pinterest, or if the traffic is coming from Google or Bing. It has a tab that'll show you all of that. There's a lot of information on it, and I highly recommend it. iTheme Security is a WordPress security plugin, and what this does is self-explanatory. It'll save your website. It'll save you a lot of headache also. And have this screen here where it'll show you one of the things it does, a strong password enforcement. It enforces your password that you have set up for your website, along with many, many other things. There's a paid version of it also, but since this video is about free plugins, I don't have the paid version. I go with the free plugin. You can see down there below, Malware Scan Scheduling Pro is what that is right there. So you can get the paid version if you like. So I will wait on something like that and just go with the free version for now. W3 Total Cache is a WordPress performance plugin. If you don't have one of these on your website, you are just waiting for an attack on your website. So you have to have some added security and some added, this thing will show you, it'll show you how well your website is performing. And that's very, very, very important, because a lot of times you'll have issues with your website, and you can go into the settings of this particular plugin. Maybe you have some enabled that shouldn't be enabled, and you can go into this plugin and disable it and so forth. Once you download the plugin, you'll see the performance tab to the left of your WordPress dashboard, and you see at the top where general page cache and all that good stuff at. That's kind of the area I was talking about. If you have something enabled that shouldn't be enabled that's affecting your website, you can always go in and disable it and so forth. There's a lot of information there. I wouldn't, if you don't know what you're doing with this particular plugin, just download it and leave it alone. if you don't know anything in terms of the use of it, download the plugin anyway, but don't go in and start messing around with something, because you can screw your website up big time. So make sure you remember that. Yoast SEO is all-in-one SEO solution for WordPress. It's a very good SEO optimize, which is search engine optimization. And what that is, it's a website where it helps you optimize your website for the search engines. This particular plugin, at the time of this recording, I do not have activated, and that's because I have a paid blog theme, which is called Optimize Press, and I'm actually using the SEO option on it. The reason that I disabled the Yoast, because I didn't want both of them coexisting on the website, and I didn't want anything to mess up. All I needed is one, so I disabled the Yoast SEO, but it's a pretty good solution for search engine optimization. It also does things like gives you a site map for your WordPress website, and that site map is something that you'll need to upload to Google as well. But with Yoast SEO, I'm telling you, it's an awesome plugin. If I didn't have the paid option, I would still already have it running on my website. Contact Form 7, it's a simple contact form. First of all, every website should have a contact page. So make sure when you're building your website that you have a contact page. And with this particular screenshot here, this is what my contact page looks like. And you notice at the top it has a captcha button, which it makes sure that it's not a robot sending you comments or comments through your contact form. I used to get that all the time before they redesigned and added the captcha to the contact form plugin. I used to get all kind of weird messages and everything, but when they added this, it completely stopped. So that's pretty cool. Simple share button adder. That's a share button for your posts and pages, and I'll show you exactly what that is. As you see on this shot here, it's the Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, all that good stuff right there. And this is the settings page. And what this does is, as you can see here, you can actually choose what social share icons that you want to use for your blog. So these are the four that I use. You can add as many as you like, and I have my posts on, so every time that I write a blog post, that will be underneath the blog. I actually have it to where it's, you see where it says placement there, it's placed at the top of the blog and at the bottom of the blog, so anyone can share whatever it is that you're writing. Broken link checker is a very important plugin as well. It checks for broken links, missing images, and notifies you as well. So you'll see a notification somewhere in your WordPress dashboard if you have a broken link on your website. And this is just the settings page for it. All the different things. You can go in there and check some stuff out from time to time. It actually will show you. You can actually set up which links to check and all of that good stuff. So it's a good plug-in, and I highly recommend it as well. Insert header and footers. This is where you can insert code in your header or the footer of your blog. From time to time, you'll see that you'll like this particular one, the Facebook pixel code. So I have a Facebook pixel code on my website, and I needed to add code to my website. So whenever you need to add code to your website, it actually keeps you from going into the editor part of your website and screwing everything up. If you're not familiar with the different HTML codes and all the other things, so make darn sure that you download this particular plugin, because it makes everything easy. You can just copy and paste the code into your header or footer. Okay, we're going to do a recap of the 10 best WordPress plugins. Number one, Askimet, and I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Number two is Google Analytics. Very important. Google Analytics dashboard for WordPress is number three. The fourth best, and iTheme Security. Number five, W3 Total Cache. Number six, Yoast SEO. Seven, Contact Form. Seven, no pun intended. Uh-oh, let me go back. I think I went a little too fast. Number eight, Simple Share Adder. Simple Share Adder. Number nine, there we go, Broken Link Checker. And number 10 that I think you should download, Insert Headers and Footers. Hey, this is not to say that you only need 10. Those are just the 10 best that I can think of in terms of importance. So there's other plugins that you may want, or that you're gonna need to use as well. So just make sure you don't have, one key is I want to make sure you don't have like 30 plugins, because if you have like 30 active plugins on your website, it's gonna slow it down big time. So make sure that you have the right ones, and it's at a nice 15, 18 number. I wouldn't have over 20 plugins, because it'll slow your site down. So 20, 25, somewhere in there. So make sure that you're not having to overuse plugins. Hey, make sure you subscribe to my channel. You'll see, should see somewhere here, or go to the front page of my YouTube channel and make sure you subscribe. Hey, thanks for watching. Thanks for spending time with me. I appreciate it. Appreciate you as well. Thank you.